How's it going, everybody? Welcome back. And today I'm going to show you guys how you can use NordVPN. This is just a bit of a beginner's guide for NordVPN on both desktop and Android or iPhone. It's really the same thing. Whether you're on Mac, Windows, Android, or iPhone, it's all going to be the same user interface. So before I begin, if you guys are interested in NordVPN or if you'd like to get straight to the pricing and discounts, be sure to check the description down below. You'll also find a full review if you'd like to learn more about NordVPN. Okay, so the very basics, really. I'll start with just showing you how you can connect to a server, and then I'll just explain the features that come with NordVPN. Okay, so as you can tell here, it's very intuitive. You just have a map design, and you're free to just zoom in with the scroll that you have on your mouse, or you can just look up servers on the left-hand side right here. You can just look whatever you want to look up here or scroll through. Usually I just find myself just zooming into the map and picking the server that I'm looking for. It's also kind of another way to brush up on my geography a little bit, so I like this design. Okay, so let's say you want to connect to the United States. All you have to do is just select the location and click it. Quick Connect will connect you to the closest, or what NordVPN thinks is the fastest server, depending on your location. Sometimes it's correct, sometimes it isn't, but I'd just rather pick a server on my own. So you just click it and you'll be connected in no time. Now, it depends on which protocol you're using. You can actually connect faster or slower depending on the protocol you're using. Right now I'm using NordLynx, which is the fastest protocol. And just go to auto connect here. And if you just go to the protocols right here, you'll find three protocols: OpenVPN, UDP, TCP, and NordLynx. Now, UDP and TCP are generally for more security. NordLynx is the WireGuard protocol, which will be the fastest protocol, and I do prefer to choose it, really, since it operates way faster. But if you are interested in more security features, as you can tell here, let me just show you guys. On the left-hand corner, you have specialty servers, Onion over VPN and peer-to-peer. Now, Onion over VPN will give you access to the dark web without having to use the Tor browser. Peer-to-peer is for peer-to-peer activities such as torrenting, but me personally, I have not found any particular advantage over using regular servers when it comes to torrenting. So, what I was trying to showcase is that if you switch to OpenVPN, be it TCP or UDP, it really doesn't matter. Let me just disconnect first because I don't want it to reconnect. If I go ahead and switch to OpenVPN, it'll actually give me two more specialty servers, so dedicated IP and double VPN. Double VPN will route your connection through two servers rather than one for extra security, barely affecting the speed, really. It's still pretty high speed. Okay, with dedicated IP, you'll always be getting the same IP address every time you return to one of these servers, rather than getting kind of scrambled IP addresses. These will give you the same IP address if you're interested in something like that. You have over 5,100 servers in total. So all these servers will amount to 5,100 plus, and you've got 60 countries. Now, there are quite a few VPNs, like ExpressVPN, for example, that has 94 countries. But as you can tell, even 60 countries is enough to kind of cover almost the entire globe, really. So, yeah, not bad at all. 60 countries is still quite a bit. Okay, so I'm going to switch to NordLynx because it is definitely the best one. And in general, by the way, you have CyberSec, which is the ad blocker. You have the kill switch, which will disable your internet when the VPN disconnects unexpectedly. And the app kill switch, which is one of the exclusive features that NordVPN has, will close selected apps when you disconnect from the VPN or the connection drops unexpectedly, rather than closing or disconnecting your entire connection as it is with the conventional kill switch. Okay, so split tiling will allow you to choose which applications are routed through the VPN and which are not. So You can, for example, pick only your browser or something else to use the VPN rather than just having your entire connection use the VPN. You'll only have the selected applications use it, or you can select certain applications to bypass the VPN while the rest of your network functions regularly through the VPN tunnel. In advance, you will see custom DNS, which will allow you to kind of set your own DNS very easily. It's an easy way to change your DNS if you're interested. And obfuscated servers will kind of obfuscate your traffic even further to make it look like you're not using a VPN in the first place if you're in a censorship heavy country. But overall, if you're in a censorship-heavy country, NordVPN will provide you with a special version of NordVPN that functions in censorship-heavy countries, and they'll give you that link through the live chat support, or you can just look it up yourself and get it. So, yeah, very simple stuff, as you can tell, you know, now that you know or have a basic idea of how to use the VPN on a PC, you'll actually be able to use it on Android. And now that we're on Android, you can tell that it's roughly the same user interface. There's barely anything changing here. The only thing that you're missing is a kill switch. And apparently, according to NordVPN themselves, the kill switch is only available on Android 8.8 in the latest phones. And I have a Huawei P10, so I guess that's not so new. And if you're on iPhone, you do have a kill switch, so no worries there. But when it comes to Android, it's only version 8.0, on the latest Android phones. You still do get CyberSec, which is an ad blocker. You get, well, half a split tunneling feature. You're only able to disable or have, you know, selected applications bypass the VPN tunnel rather than use it. So it's kind of half a split tunneling feature. You have auto connect options, obviously, and you have a the same selection of protocols. Custom DNS, and two features that you only get, of course, on your phone. You're not going to find those on the PC. Tap jacking protection, which will alert you if a malicious app adds a screen overlay to trick you into an unintended action. And dark web monitor is another feature which will alert you if your credentials get publicly exposed online. So that's pretty much it. Besides that, the UI is very similar, as you can tell, and all you have to do is just select one of these pins and you'll be able to connect. It really is as simple as that. So that'll be it for this video. Hopefully you guys kind of learned how to use a NordVPN. If you guys have any more questions, please post them in the comments down below. I'll be happy to answer all of them. Keep in mind that you'll also find links to special deals and discounts in the description down below, as well as a full review if you'd like to learn more about NordVPN with regards to the privacy policy, speed streaming and torrenting capabilities, as well as security and features. Also, NordVPN does offer a 30-day money-back guarantee on all of its plans, so no matter which plan you get, you are able to get yourself the refund if you're not satisfied for one reason or another, and you can claim it through the live chat support, which is also available 24/7. So yeah, great stuff overall. Like and subscribe if you'd like to support the channel and stay up to date with everything VPNs and cybersecurity. Thank you guys very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Have a wonderful day.